It's time to start your engine. Climb aboard Bob's Magic Bus. We're going on a new adventure. We're going to meet new friends, learn new things, sing some songs, and most of all, have lots of fun for the next little while. So sit in your seats and hold on tight.
Boys and girls, welcome aboard Bob's Magic Bus. So nice to have you all aboard again. This will be our last show for the spring-summer season. However, we will be back again in the fall. So we've put together a very special show for you today. We have a children's author dropping by to read us a story, Miss Jodie Marie Thornbury. We have two musical guests, my good friend Todd Barteau and Shanneyganock. Of course, we're going to meet our final new friend. This friend has a very unique talent. Throughout the COVID-19 virus, people have found many different ways to help them cope with the isolation and being separated from family and friends. Some people turn to yoga or other types of meditation, while others turn to God with prayers. This next song is a spiritual song that we can all relate to. It's called Put Your Hand in the Hand. Please join me. It's a very uplifting song.
Steals the water. Put your hand in the hand of a man who calms the sea. Take a look at yourself and you can look at others differently. Put your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Every time I look into the holy book, I wanna tremble.
Put your hand in the hand of a man.
Boys and girls, we have one final tip to help you stay safe during this COVID-19 virus. And it is, stay in your bubble, protect your bubble, and don't burst anyone else's bubble. Quite simply, that means you should only hang out with people who are in your double bubble. And now we have 6 more people that we can have as part of our extended bubble. If you only hang out with those people and keep yourself a safe distance, 6 feet, 2 arms length, 1 fathom away from all others, you will be safe. So remember, stay in your bubble, protect your bubble, and don't burst anyone else's.
In the Art Corner today, our new friend is going to teach you how to draw my favorite spring and summertime food. It's a watermelon. What better food than a watermelon on a hot day? So please welcome our new friend, Liam.
Welcome back to another video. Before the video starts, make sure to hit the notification and hit the thumbs up. And today we are going to be drawing a watermelon.
Go through and so you can do your first step.
Okay, first step, we're gonna make a big line across. Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna make a long one, but not that. Then we're gonna do that, and that, and...
And what is that for? What is that supposed to be?
A bite.
A bite out of the watermelon, good.
And next one, we're gonna be drawing these eyes. So the eyes are going to be really close together. This one we are going to be drawing. Hey! Another one. And then next is one cross and then a mouth. Drawing that in the wicked wood. Like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we are going to be drawing that side of it.
Mm-hmm.
But except not drawing the little circle. And then there we go. And now we're supposed to do this. To color it, and do a seat. Gonna color it. We're gonna be coloring the wine part. So make sure you don't do that to the wands. Make sure. bum, 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 bum. Bing, ding, 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 ding.
Red, like the color of a watermelon.
If you messed up, you can start over and pause it.
Mm-hmm.
And catch up. Hi guys, here's my finished watermelon. It's your turn to draw yours. Peace out for now. Look out for some more videos.
Our special guest this week on Listen to the Music is Mr. Todd Barteau. Todd has been performing around the Avalon Peninsula for the past number of years. His unique mix of country, Irish, and folk music has kept him quite busy. So boys and girls, let's give Todd a great big magic bus welcome.
Hey kids, I hope everybody's doing good during this COVID-19 time. I want to say special thanks to Mr. Bob Tarrant for inviting me to come on and entertain you with a song. I am from a little town called Bryan's Cove where I grew up and learned how to play guitar when I was about 13 years old. Took guitar lessons and played guitar in school and was taught by my family and my friends to play songs and sing songs. And I've pretty much been doing it ever since. My wife, Christy, is here, and Riley. And we have two dogs, Skipper and Maverick, that could possibly bark anytime during this song, because they bark anytime there's any noise outside or a car coming or anything, any company. Anyway, here's my song. This is a song by a Newfoundland group called Buddy Wass's Name and the Other Fellers. They've been playing music around Newfoundland for, I guess, 35 years or so. So a very long time, even before, well, around the same time that I was just learning how to play guitar. Anyway, so I hope you enjoy the song. This is called Saltwater Joys. I hope you enjoy it. Just to wake up in the morning to the quiet of the cold, hear Aunt Bessie talking to herself, and they hear poor Uncle John mumbling wishes to old Nell, made me feel like everything's fine. I was born down by the water, so here I'm gonna stay. I've searched for all the reasons why I should go away, but I haven't got the thirst for all those modern day toys, so I'll just take my chances with those saltwater joys. Following a little brook as it trickles to the shore, the autumn when the trees are flaming red, kicking leaves that fall around me, watching sunset paint the hills, is all I'll ever need to feel at home. This island that we cling to has been handed down with pride by folks who fought to live here, taking hardships all in stride. So I'll compliment your beauty, hold on to my goodbyes, and I'll stay and take my chances with those saltwater joys. How can I leave those mornings with the sunrise on the cove and gulls like flies surrounding Plato's wharf? When Platter's Island wrapped in rainbow in the evening after fog, and ocean smells are perfume to my soul. Some go to where the buildings reach to meet the clouds, where warm and gentle people turn swarm in faceless crowds. But I'll do without their riches, glamour and the noise, and I'll stay and take my chances with those saltwater joys. Some go to where the buildings reach to meet the clouds, where warm and gentle people turn swarm in faceless crowd. But I'll do without their riches, glamour and the noise, and I'll stay, take my chances with those saltwater joys. Yes, I'll stay, take my chances with those saltwater joys. Thanks very much. Stay safe, everybody.
Come along, boys and girls. It's time to gather round. It's story time. Today, on story time, we have a very special guest. We have children's author Jodie Marie Thornbury. So boys and girls, let's get nice and comfy. Sit back and enjoy the story.
Cattails from the Funny Farm. Hello, my name is Newman P. Thornbury. I've lived on this earth for 23 human years. I wonder how many cat years that is. I know it must be a lot because I feel tired. For the first 7 years of my life, I was homeless. Nobody loved me. I was sad and scared, which made me act mean and angry sometimes. I was cold and wet, living in a dirty shed, eating potato peels from the garbage. Life was rough. Then a kind lady named Jodie saved me from life on the streets. Everything completely changed when she adopted me. I never had fuzzy blankets, comfy beds, home-cooked meals, and cuddles before. Life is great. Moving into a human house was the best decision I ever made. I wish I had thought of it sooner, though. I love my humans. Every cat should have at least a couple. These days, I live on a farm with two humans, two horses, a very curious kitten, dozens of ducks, 400 frogs, and too many squirrels to count. I don't like those squirrels at all. The humans say I'm crooked in my old age. Whatever that means. Maybe crooked means I love hunting, exploring, and chasing squirrels by myself. The humans call themselves my mom and dad. They love me, feed me, and keep me warm and protect me. So I guess they are like my mom and dad, even though they're humans. And I'm a feline. My mom shares all her food with me, but sometimes I get greedy and eat my share first when she's not looking. We love watching movies in bed together, snacking and cuddling. Me and my dad watch all the sports on TV in our favorite chair. I don't even like sports, but I love cuddles and snacks. My Nan visits me at the farm. We love taking long naps together. She snores and wakes me up a lot. but she buys the best treats and tells the best stories. Today I was looking for a chicken nugget that I lost, and I stumbled across a box of old diaries in a secret hiding place that I had forgot about. My memory isn't what it used to be, and I never did find that chicken nugget. I only have a few lives left from the 9 lives I was given as a kitten. I feel old, but very wise. I have learned a lot, and I'd like to share my stories with you. I hope you enjoy my cat tales from the funny farm. Dear Diary, I really love life on the farm. I chased 5 squirrels today. They may be fast, but so am I. I almost caught one of them. I hope they come back and bring their friends. I want to chase them all. I'm the boss and fearless leader of all the ducks, frogs, squirrels, and mice around this place. Life is good. Dear Diary, today I overheard Mom and Dad talking about getting horses. What are horses? Are they bigger than dogs? I've never heard of them before. I'll ask around the farm and find out. Mom and Dad built these horses a house where they will live by themselves. It's called a barn. I wonder why horses need their own place to live. I've never heard of such a thing. They bought lots of hay too and put it in the barn. I wonder what they'll use that hay for. Dear Diary, a big truck pulling a box with wheels arrived today. They opened that box and out jumped those horses. I don't know what all the fuss is about. They look like big clumsy dogs with funny feet. How do they even catch mice with those things? They look different. I've decided I don't like them. Dear Diary, I spent half the day ignoring those horses and the other half looking at them with my angry eyes. I think they got the message. I hope they go away soon. Mom and Dad say I'm jealous. I wonder what jealous means. I'll ask around the farm and find out. Dear Diary, I think I should dress up as a squirrel for Halloween. I'll wear my costume to trick the squirrels. If I become one of them and gain their trust, I might catch one. That sounds like too much work, though. And my sewing machine is broken. Maybe I'll just try on this wig first. Dear Diary, even though the horses have been living here on my farm for a few years now, I barely notice them half the time. To be honest, they bore me. And you know what? They poop a lot. Mom complains about cleaning my litter box all the time, but never says anything about shoveling out that barn. That shovel is 10 times bigger than my pooper scooper, just saying. And another thing, horses don't eat meat. They eat hay all day and a few vegetables. Who doesn't eat meat? Seriously? Not even a few mice? What tiny little squirrel? A single chunk of bacon? Ever? I don't believe it. Dear Diary, today I was hiding in the bushes, spying on my duck families in the pond, when those two troublemakers, Thelma and Louise, showed up. They're Mom's favorite ducks. She just loves them. Thelma and Louise waddle across the lawn and come right up to the house. Mom and Dad find this very exciting for some reason. Then Mom always puts me inside the house because she doesn't trust me. I don't know what that means. I'll ask around the farm and find out. Dear Diary, today I chased those ducks all around the lawn. Thelma and Louise overreacted, if you ask me. Mom is mad at me now for scaring her ducks, so I'm mad at her for being mad at me. I hope none of those squirrels saw me get in trouble. I'll never hear the end of it. Dear Diary, Mom and Dad built a little deck on the back pond for me to sit and watch the frogs in comfort. Sometimes Mom likes to sit and drink coffee with me. Well, she drinks coffee. I can't. It keeps me awake all night. Mom calls this relaxing. I call it research. I don't trust those frogs. I need to keep my eye on them. Dear diary, today was the summer garden party on the farm. There was a big carnival wheel for the kids to spin, and they won prizes and teddy bears. We had a bonnet contest and even got to fly a kite. Dad was in charge of the hot dogs. He burns a lot of them, but I don't mind because I get to eat those ones. Dear diary, this farm is getting a little bit crowded. Horses, ducks, frogs, mice, and those nutty squirrels are everywhere. I feel outnumbered. I'm beginning to believe I'm too different to fit in around here. I'm all alone. Maybe I'm the last of my kind. Am I the only cat left on the planet? I panicked there for a minute. What was I talking about? Dear diary, Mom and Dad told me today that I'm getting a baby brother. They think I need a friend because I'm lonely. I'm not lonely, and I don't need any more friends. I'm too busy running this farm. They showed me a picture of him. He's a cat like me, and he has white fur like me. He's really small, though, and not as handsome as me, of course. Dear diary, well, the kitten has arrived. My little brother. I don't know how to feel. One day I was king of the castle, boss of the farm, owner of all the food, fuzzy blankets, beds and toys. Now all I hear is, Newman, be a good boy. Newman, share with the baby. Newman, don't hurt your little brother. This kitten is annoying. Sure, he's cute and fluffy and oh so tiny, but he also bites and jumps on me a lot and tries to eat all my food. I think kittens are almost as bad as squirrels. Almost. Dear diary, they named my little brother Magoo. What kind of silly name is that? He follows me everywhere. And copies everything I do. He tries to impress me all the time. Look how fast I can run. Watch me roll around. See how high I can jump. Oh, he's such a show-off. Look at me, look at me, look at me. Magoo really is fast, though. I might show him a few squirrel chasing tricks. We are very different, but we have a lot in common. He eats meat and has a litter box just like me. He likes to sit in the basket and watch people in the bathroom. And I like to drink from the toilet. Dear diary, I'm not scared of those horses anymore. Sometimes I get scared of things that are different. But if you give anyone a chance, you might find we're not so different after all. I like the horses a little more every day. Definitely more than those squirrels. Dear diary, I'm starting to really like having a baby brother. It's nice having someone on the farm who looks like me. Magoo is a show-off. He's very small and he can't meow properly yet. But nobody is perfect. I love him anyway. That's how family works. Even though we may disagree sometimes, and we may not even like each other at times, we accept and love each other all the time. But I do know this, I will never, ever, ever like squirrels. No squirrels allowed. Thank you for listening to my little story. Have a great day.
Well, boys and girls, we've come to the end of our final episode of Bob's Magic Bus for this season. I'd like to thank our special new friend, Liam, a very talented young artist. Thank you to children's author, Miss Jodie Marie Thornbury, for reading the story. My good musical friend, Mr. Todd Barteau, and our special musical guest, Shanneyganock. We look forward to seeing you again next fall, and I'm going to let Shanneyganock take you out of this episode with their special tribute to children in their brand new hit single. See you again, boys and girls, on Bob's Magic Bus.
Hi guys, it's great to be here on Bob's Magic Bus. I hope you have a safe summer, and here's an old tune for you called The Blackbird.
None, we're Newfoundlanders, we're not afraid of nothing.
Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
How's your father?
All right.
All my life I'm on the farm working for me keep. Tending pigs and chickens, and the cows and sheep. But everywhere I'm working, there's always one that mocks me. He's hiding somewhere in the trees, Blackbird, I'll have him.
Where be the blackbird too, I know where he be. He be out yon myrtle tree, and I be after he. Now I sees he sees I, barking if I don't get him. With a ripping stick, I'll knock him down, Blackbird, I'll have him.
Na 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 na.
How's your fodder?
All right.
Underneath the open sky in spring, we love to dine. We like to hear the flapping of the Mrs. Washing line. We listens to a tuneful song, a blackbird or a kit. Put on me vest and underpants, he's for the direct hit.
Where be the blackbird too? I know where he be. He be off yon myrtle tree and I be after he. Now I sees he sees I, fucker if I don't get him. With a ripping stick I'll knock him down, blackbird I'll have he.
Na 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 na.
How's your fodder?
All right.
If I goes out poaching, a creeping through the fields, with me old retriever, a fallen rag me heels. If I aim me shotgun at a pheasant in the hay, that bloody blackbird starts his round, frightens him away.
Where be the blackbird too? I know where he be. He be up yon wurzel tree and I be after he. Now I sees he sees I, for if I don't get him, with a great big stick I'll knock him down, blackbird I'll have he.
Na 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 na.
How's your fodder?
All right.
No longer can I sleep at night, get peace of any kind. That bird'll be the death of me, he's preying on me mine. If I chase him long enough, I'll get him by and by, and celebrate me victory with a great, great blackbird pie.
Where be the blackbird too? I know where he be. He be off yon wurzel tree, and I be after he. Now I sees he sees I, fucker if I don't get him. With a great big stick, I'll knock him down, blackbird, I'll have he. With a great big stick, I'll knock him down, blackbird, I'll have he.
Na 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 na.
How's your father?
Shanneyganock has just released a brand new album. It's called The Logie Bay Woodstove Sessions, featuring Blackbird and many, many other Newfoundland and traditional favorites. Pick up your copy today. They won't last long. This album will be available at all fine music stores and online. Check out Shanneyganock on Facebook for more information.